Hello students, welcome to the second video of your science, Modes of Nutrition. So here you can see a flow chart. This is a flow chart of the modes of nutrition. In this it is written autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition are the main two modes of nutrition. One is autotrophic nutrition, the other is heterotrophic nutrition. And again, the mode of heterotrophic nutrition is divided into saprotrophic nutrition, parasitic nutrition, and holozoic nutrition. And in the previous video, we have discussed saprotrophic and parasitic nutrition. Now, another method is holozoic nutrition. That is not the nutrition in plants. That is a method of nutrition in animals. Holozoic nutrition is a method of nutrition in animals. We will discuss about it later. Nutrition in animals. In the chapter, nutrition in animals, that is the second chapter. In that chapter, we will discuss about holozoic nutrition. Now, I have already told you about the type of saprotrophic nutrition and parasitic nutrition and examples. Now you draw this flow chart. You draw this flow chart in your copy. So this is your, if you have arranged old books, if you have an old book of science, you can see in the second page there is modes of nutrition and you write this. This is the first homework for you. Write down the mode of nutrition. Now I have made a concept map. I have made a concept map of same. Concept map of nutrition. This is a concept map. Modes of nutrition. Same thing. Just like a flowchart, we can make a concept map to understand the main concepts of nutrition. So what are the main concepts of nutrition? This is also concept of modes of nutrition. There are two type of nutrition, autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition. Autotrophic nutrition is the mode of nutrition in which green plants prepare their own food. Heterotrophic nutrition is the mode of nutrition in which organism cannot prepare their own food, so they depend on other organisms for food. Organism cannot prepare their own food, so they depend on other organisms for food. You note it down in your copy. You write down like this. Differentiate, list down the differences between autotrophic. List down the differences between autotrophic mode of nutrition and heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Now you differentiate it. Here you write autotrophic mode of nutrition. Here you write autotrophic mode of nutrition. And the next column, heterotrophic mode. Heterotrophic mode. Now complete this column. Now you write here difference one. First difference is in autotrophic mode of nutrition, what happened? The mode of nutrition in which green plants prepare their own food is called autotrophic mode of nutrition. Autotrophic mode of nutrition. Here you write the same 0.1 Organism cannot prepare their own food. Organisms cannot prepare their own food, so they depend on other organisms for food. Organism cannot prepare their own food, so they depend on other organisms for food in heterotrophic mode of nutrition. So, second point, simple raw materials CO2 carbon dioxide and water are used to prepare food. Simple raw materials, carbon dioxide and water, underline carbon dioxide and water, are used to prepare food. Here, plants cannot prepare their own food, so they depend on other organisms for food. Here, what happened? The prepared food is utilized. The prepared food by plants, by green plants, is here you write depend on the prepared food, depend on the prepared food by green plants directly or indirectly. Depend on the prepared food by green plants directly or indirectly. Here the example in autotrophic nutrition is all green plants. Here the example in heterotrophic nutrition is animals and non-green plants like a fungi. Animals and non-green plants like a fungi. So this is the difference between autotrophic and heterotrophic mode of nutrition. And now you write this concept map. See this concept map, write it down in your copy. So write this concept map. In autotrophic nutrition, there is no subgroup. Only example is given, green plants. In heterotrophic nutrition, there are three subgroups, parasitic, saprotrophic and one is parasitic. Second is saprotrophic and the third one is holozoic. So three subgroups are there, two, second and third. This is one, parasitic, saprotrophic and holozoic mode of nutrition, holozoic. Now parasitic example, animal, leech, plant, cuscuta or dodder. Cuscuta or dodder. Saprotrophic mushroom, holozoic, human being, amoeba, etc. are examples of holozoic mode of nutrition. So this is a concept map. See, concept map on nutrition. See, now before winding up this video, we have learned only one portion, that is the difference between autotrophic and heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Today I am teaching you very slowly, only one concept I have given you, types of nutrition only I have given you today, because slow and steady we have to go forward, but it should be thoroughly. You should know all these things thoroughly, and you have to understand all these things. So write it down, learn it again and again. If you have the book, read it again and again. Try to understand what is written in the book and what is written in the notes also. In these notes, learn it from day one. You start learning. This is the flow chart given in your book. So this flow chart also you have to write. It is here in your book. I have already shown you the flow chart. This is your chapter. Nutrition in living organisms, plants. This is your first chapter. You don't have new books. That is why I am showing you the book chapter. I am showing you because you don't have book. Most of you don't have books. If you arranged one, then it is very good. Read the book. So now that in the next video, I will teach you, or we will learn detailly about photosynthesis. We will learn detailly about photosynthesis, the food making process, in the next video. Till then, bye. Thank you.